I'll start by creating a new project. I'll name the custom grid view. Firstly, drag a horizontal linear and set its height to match parent. We'll use it to show the grid view. Secondly, a list view is needed to connect the grid view to a custom view, so drag it to the action screen. Next, create a custom view and name it anything. This is where the grid view item will be. For me, I've decided to put an image as my item, so I'll just drag an image view. Here, I'll create a number variable to help the grid view add the number of items to it. I will give it a name of grid items. After that, I'll set this number variable to 0. Next, I'll create a list map named grid contents. You can set the name to anything you want. Go to controls and take the repeat block. Its function will be to set the number of items on the grid view. In the repeat block, I'll increase the number variable by 1. This will increase to 10 times using the repeat block. Use the add key block to add values to the list view and to the grid view. I'll set the key as item and the value to string the number of items. I have this code that I modified to show the grid view. I'm going to place it outside of the repeat block so it doesn't multiply. I defined the name of the grid view as A and used it to set its layout parent. I then set our list view's adapter to the list map I created. Since our list map is named grid content, I'll change it in this line. Below this, I've set the number of columns of the grid view to 4. This linear is useful, as it is what we use to show the grid view. The last thing to do is to connect the list view to our custom view. The onBind event automatically appears once the custom view is connected. I need the onBind to set an action whenever our image from custom view is clicked. And if it's clicked, it will show a toast message of its number position. As always, we compile whenever everything is done. As you can see, the items have all appeared in grid view style. And all the items are 10 in number. Plus, I think you've already noticed that the grid's columns are 4 each. I'll try and change the grid's columns to 3 and the number of items to 30. I'll change the number of items using the repeat block, just like we did before. Thank you. it worked. The total number of items is 30, and the columns are 3 each. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video.